Hello, welcome to our service together this Sunday morning, the 29th of March. The clocks have now gone forward as you watch this on Sunday morning. We're into British summertime, and though we continue to find ourselves in this strange and unsettling time when we are largely confined to our homes, yet we can still be together through means like this, and we're thankful for modern technology and the opportunities that it gives us. The opportunity to worship together, perhaps in a way that we're not used to, but yet we can still do that. There's also another video this morning with some words from Simon linking into a more in-depth sermon which you can read, which should be available on the church website. But now we come just to some words of prayer as we begin. Psalm 121 says this: I lift my eyes up to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. And so, Father, we thank you that wherever we may be and however we may be feeling today, our help comes from you, and you are with us. And we can draw near to you now in worship and in prayer. So we are thankful. Amen. And it may be that over these last few days, with the sun shining, you've been able to enjoy some time in the garden, or some time out for walks. And that's been a real blessing for us as a family this week. And we're reminded of the wonder of God's creation and the opportunities to be out in it. Which is a link into a first opportunity that we have to sing together this morning. So I encourage you to join in now as we worship God by singing, O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder. O Lord my God, then sings my soul. Sings my soul, my Savior, God to you. As you're watching this at home, I ask you just to take a look around you in the room where you are. You might be sitting in your kitchen or in your living room or somewhere else in your house. That's the place where you live. It's the place where you spend most of your time, particularly, of course, in the times that we find ourselves in at the moment. And the way that you arrange your furniture, the way that you decorate your home, will reflect who you are and what your priorities are, and how you seek to live your life. And so for us here, we're in our living room at home, and we've got comfy chairs where we like to relax. You can't see them, but there are toys around on the floor that the children play with. There are books on the shelves that we read, things around us that we need and that we want to place around us to help in our daily lives and to reflect what's important to us. So where we live, where we dwell, reflects who we are and what our priorities in life might be. And today, as we've been continuing over these last few weeks, looking at studies in the book of Exodus, we come now to think about making a dwelling place for God and how God gave instructions to his people to do that with the building of the tabernacle. And I've been struck as we've been looking at Exodus over the last few weeks, just how much it has to say, particularly into the difficult and strange circumstances in which we now find ourselves. And this reading today is no exception. So please do continue to take time to study Exodus, even though we can't meet together for those studies anymore. We can still do that in our own homes if you have the study guide. Please do continue to use it and benefit from it, and we can share things that we're learning through email and phone conversations and social media and so on. But we come now to look at this next passage in Exodus, Exodus chapter 25 and verses 1 to 9. And Daniel is going to read for us now. So Daniel.
The Lord said to Moses, "Tell the people of Israel to bring me an offering. You must receive the offerings for me from everyone whose hearts move them to give. Here are the offerings you must receive from them: gold, silver and bronze, blue, purple and bright red yarn, and fine linen, goat hair, ram skins that are dyed red, another kind of strong leather, acacia wood, olive oil for the lights, spices for the anointing oil and for the sweet-smelling incense, onyx stones and other jewels for the linen approach and chest cloth. Have them made a sacred tent for me. I will live among them. Make the holy tent and everything that belongs to it. Make them exactly like the pattern I will show you."
Thank you, Daniel. So really detailed instructions follow on from there about the construction of the tabernacle, of the things that will go in it, the materials that are to be used. It is a great detail, great amount of space and time in the book of Exodus is devoted to this. So it's clearly very important. Important because this is to be God's dwelling place. And actually, the key verse from what we've just heard, verse 8, where the Lord says to Moses, "Then let them make a sanctuary for me, and I will dwell among them." So So God has rescued his people from slavery in Egypt. He has given them the law to show them how to live well. And now he is going to come and to dwell amongst them. So they are becoming his people. And this is a significant moment from them. A significant moment for them. But what does it mean for us? What does it mean in the light of the New Testament? In the light of Jesus? Well, actually, if we look to the beginning of John's Gospel, and we have those really important words that we sometimes hear read often at Christmas time, from John 1 and verse 14, where it says, "The Word became flesh and made his dwelling amongst us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth." And the language that John uses here actually calls to mind the idea of the tabernacle in Exodus. Jesus, the Word made flesh, making his dwelling amongst his people. Just as God in the tabernacle coming to dwell amongst the Israelites in the wilderness. And so with Jesus, the Word, God is coming and is tabernacling amongst his people. And that includes us. The modern message paraphrase of the Bible puts that verse from John like this. It says, "The Word became flesh and blood and moved into the neighbourhood." So our Lego tabernacle here, if we move that for a moment and replace it with a house. Not sure whether any of your houses look anything like that, but one of the Lego houses that we've got, just to symbolise perhaps where you live, your neighbourhood, the kind of house, the kind of place where you might live. The Word became flesh and moved into the neighbourhood. And this is such an important reminder for us at a time like this, when we can't be gathered together in our church buildings, because it reminds us that God is not confined to a building. That there is no longer a need for a tabernacle as there was in the time of the Old Testament, in the time of Exodus. There is no longer a need for that special place where God dwells, because now God dwells among his people. God dwells with us, in our neighbourhoods, in our homes, in the places where we live. A reminder that, yes, of course, we're grateful for our church buildings and all that they mean to us. But ultimately, the church is not the building, but the people, you and I, God's people in this community. And so God is with us wherever we are. We can worship him and draw near to him wherever we are. So just dwell on that thought for a moment. The Word became flesh and moved into the neighbourhood, moved into your neighbourhood. Think about the neighbourhood where you live. Think about the people living around you at this time. You may not be able to see them in the way that you normally could, but they're still there. And they still have needs and issues, just as all people do. But maybe something that you could do during this time of isolation, this time when we're confined largely to our homes, is to think about your neighbourhood, to think about the place where God has placed you, and to think about the way in which God is there with you, that God dwells with you because you are there. You might want to think about those around you, living nearby. You might want to make a list of those you know, and even those you don't know, in the houses around and about. You might want to use perhaps a map to think about those who live around you on the streets nearby. Whatever means is helpful to you, perhaps, to think so that you can think about those around you and be praying for those around you and thinking about how you can help them, perhaps encourage them, perhaps support them, whether it's through a phone call or some other thing that you can do at this time. Even though we are confined to our homes and we cannot meet together as we would love to be able to do, God is with us. God is with you in the place, in the neighbourhood where he's put you. And within that place, you can draw close to him and know his love. And who knows, there may be amazing opportunities also to share his love with those around you in the midst of these strange times. So as we think on that, we're going to move now into a time to pray. And another member of our congregation, Lily Barber, is going to lead us in prayer now.
Dear God, give us strength in these unknown and difficult times. Love, protect and help our NHS workers and those giving up their time to help those in need. For the doctors, nurses and carers that are tending to the sick. Also for delivery drivers and supermarket workers who keep the nation running. Guide them. We pray for those who may be anxious or distressed. Comfort them and give them courage. We pray for those who are sick and that they will return to good health as quickly as possible. Lord God, hear our prayer. Amen.
And so now we're going to gather our prayers together by saying the prayer that Jesus taught us, and Joe's going to lead us in prayer. So let's pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Amen. Amen. So, the first particular thing to take away from today, I think, is that reminder that wherever we might be, God is with us. God dwells with us. God is the one who in Jesus comes into our world to live amongst us and to be with us in all times and in all that we might go through. Even though we can't be together in a church building, God is with us and we are his church. But the other thing, just to say quickly, drawing on the story of the building of the tabernacle, is that in Exodus chapter 31, we find mention of two particular characters, Bezalel and Oholiab. And these two men are those whom God chooses, and they are craftspeople, and they use all sorts of skills to work in the building and the construction of the tabernacle and all that will go in it. And in particular, it says of Bezalel, God says, I have filled him with the Spirit of God, with wisdom, with understanding and knowledge, with all kinds of skills. So here we have the first mention of someone who is filled with God's Spirit for that particular task of making and doing all that artistic work of building and designing the tabernacle. And a reminder of God's creativity given to his people through the gifts of the Spirit. And that applies to us today as well. We too have gifts. We too receive God's Spirit to equip us for the things that he calls us to do. And just as God is creative in all that he does, so too we share his creativity, just as Bezalel and Oholiab did back in the time of the building of the tabernacle. So maybe you have an opportunity to use your God-given creativity in this time when you're at home. We're going to sing about that in a song, another all-age song that has actions, which I encourage you to join in with if you can. We're going to sing together, Creator God. You put the stars in outer space. You pop the freckles on my face. And all the fish that swim and all the birds that fly were made of your incredible imagination. Creator God, we sing to the God of all the world, Creator God, we celebrate you, we celebrate you. You spread the ripples through the sea, you painted stripes on every beam, you put the heat into the sun. You place the heart in everyone. And all the music plays and all the dancing done reminds us that we're here to be created by Creator God. To sing to the Creator God of all the world. Creator God, we celebrate you. We celebrate you. So this week, wherever you might be, know that God is with you, that God dwells with you. You're part of his church, part of his people, and he is with you by his Spirit. And maybe within that, there is also the opportunity for you to be creative with your God-given gifts and all that God blesses you with. Maybe you'll have an opportunity. Look for those opportunities this week. And please do stay in touch, even though we can't be together in person. There are opportunities to stay connected through email and telephone and social media, through our Facebook page for Wareham's Church of England family, and our YouTube channel, and of course the parish website. So please do stay in touch and let us know how you are. Also, a reminder that we're encouraged to continue to light a candle if it's safe to do so, and place it in our window at 7 p.m. each evening. If you're able to do that, please do join in with that opportunity to pause and to pray for the continuing situation that our nation finds itself in. But now we finish with a prayer of blessing. And may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you. May the Lord turn his face towards you and give you his peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and all those you know and love, now and always.